If you've gone through any WordPress tutorials, you've probably seen or been asked to add custom code snippets in your theme's functions.php file or a site-specific plugin. And if you're like most people, that just ran shivers down your spine out of nervousness. And that's because the problem with this is any slightest mistake on this can break your website completely. But don't worry, in this video, I'll walk you through how you can easily and simply add custom code snippets in WordPress without breaking your website. So let's dive in. The best way to do this is we're going to install a plugin. This plugin can handle and replace 6 to 8 or even more plugins on your website just by installing it. Plus, it'll allow you, anytime you see a tutorial that says install a snippet of code or add a snippet of code on your site, then you'll be able to put it here and know that it's okay. So let's head over to our plugins section. We'll go add new. And in the search bar, we're looking for WP code. This is the one we want. Now, you may already have this. If you've ever gone through any of our tutorials, we always talked about installing insert headers and footers. That was perfect for installing any type of script for a third party. Like if you wanted to verify Pinterest or if you wanted to add Google Analytics without a plugin, you would do that. Now they have renamed it to WP code because they've expanded their functionality to add snippets of code. So once we install it, let's go ahead and activate it. And now we see code snippets over here. Under code snippets, if we click on the code snippets, then this will show us any of the code snippets that are being used. We also have a status area over here if it's enabled or disabled. And then when we want to add a new one, you can simply click add new. What I also love about this is you can add blank snippets. So if you have a bit of code from a tutorial and you want to put that here, then you can do that. But there's also all of these snippets that have been tried and true. So if there's something that you're wanting to do, you may want to check this library of snippets that have been vetted by professional developers in WordPress to make sure that this works for you. To show you how it works, I'm going to click on blank snippet and then we're going to give it a title. I'm just going to do something really basic, like removing the WordPress version. And then I'm going to add this bit of code that I found on the written tutorial on WP Beginner. Over on the right, we also want to make sure that we get the correct type of snippet. So this is a PHP snippet because this is PHP function. Scrolling down, you want to choose how to insert this. By default, it'll be auto insert, and then you can choose where to run it. You can run it everywhere. Front end only, admin only, and all of these others. If you're not really sure, just go ahead and just select run everywhere and that will run throughout your entire site. You can also choose to do short code, meaning once I save this, we can copy the short code and that's more specific if we need to put it on a particular page or a post, then you have that. For many people, we'll be using the auto insert. Scrolling down, we have this basic section here where you can add tags. You can also assign a priority, meaning if you have multiple snippets, then maybe you want to run one of these over another. 10 is the default, but if you want to run something over anything else, then you want to set it a lower number, like 5 or something would be good. And then just to keep track of what you're doing with your website, it's always a good idea to give a note to yourself so you know what you're doing. You can also assign tags to your code snippet. This just helps you sort code by the snippet, by topic or functionality. So that's really helpful if you have multiple snippets that you're working on. And then you can also do smart conditional logic. This is perfect if you want to only show or hide things on particular posts or pages, things like that. So you can show, and these are all the items, whether they're logged in, particular user role, like I said, a post type or a page. And if somebody is referring, you can do it like that. And then you can also stack them. This is really handy if you're wanting, like I said, to put something on a post, then you can do a conditional on that as well. When you're done filling everything out, then we can just go ahead and click Save Snippet. And it's still inactive. So once you save it, then you'll want to make it active and then it will remove the version from contributors. And now you remember the part where we talk about if you add the code or the snippet wrong, you're afraid you're going to break your site. A lot of times that happens. And this is where WP Code does an amazing job, is if you accidentally put something in here that shouldn't be in there, and you try to update it, it actually makes the snippet inactive and also give you a warning that you need to fix something before it can go live. The other cool thing is if you are making an error, somewhere while you're writing the code, then it'll give you some ideas of what is going on. And you can hover over it to see what it's telling you. And then I already showed you the basically the dashboard area where you can see the status of all of your snippets, what's being used and what is not on your site, so you can keep track of that. You also have an area under tools where you can import. So if you've done the snippet part before with another plugin, you can import those snippets here. Or also if you are creating another site and you want to export the same snippets that you have, then you can do that here as well. And then finally, if you're ever having to troubleshoot your site with, say, support team or what have you, they usually ask you for system information for your website. And right from here, you get really cool information that you can share with the support team if you need to. Now that you see a little bit about this, take a look around and see all the snippets that you can add to your site right now. You can do things like disable comments with these snippets. Simply use the snippet, add it to your site, enable it, and now you have no more comments on your site. Take a look through the whole library and let us know in the comments below which one is your favorite snippet to use on your website. And thanks for watching.